Seems like a nice, cozy little place. Nice and quiet. Must be the off-season, eh?
Stand on the line.
What?
On the line.
What line?
Are you trying to be smart?
No.
Then stand on the line.
Well, I would if I could see it.
Are you calling me a liar?
No.
Then stand on the line. What are you, stupid? I said on the line, not 2 feet off it.
You show me where the line is and I'll stand on it.
It's behind you. Wasn't so hard, was it?
Rita Connors.
What about her?
Her transfer to Blackmore was a mistake. I want her out of there.
You're joking.
I most certainly am not.
Well, it's been done, and your chief troublemaker's out of your hair.
I put a lot of work into her. She was just beginning to respond.
I've seen no evidence of it. Unless you mean her attempt to murder another inmate and tear the prison shop to pieces.
I'm not convinced that's what happened.
Well, I have read the reports, and I am satisfied.
How can you talk about reform one moment and condone such a major injustice the next?
Because it is that major injustice, as you call it, that proves we're serious. Let's face it, you are going to have enough trouble making this program work without Connors here to undermine you.
Surely that should be my decision.
A decision has been taken. It's been seen to be taken. It cannot be reversed without a damn good reason.
Okay, you're on your own.
Yeah. Well, if we're still at it when you come back, we're gonna stop.
Okay, girls, give them a bit of fight. Room ringside seats are free today, courtesy of the management.
Come on, Maxwell, call it. Show everyone what you ain't made of.
Hey, Charlie!
Oh, geez, girls, I'm real scared.
Oh, man,
a sense of humour. Likes to tease us by parading them in round once in a while.
Yeah. Do we get to mix in with them at all?
Nah. We get to see him in church sometimes, but that's about it.
Bongo!
Friend of yours?
It's me brother. I thought he was in Woodridge.
He's been in here for about 3 weeks. Sorry to tell you this, but he's a real junkie. Rue keeps him supplied. I reckon he'll end up like the rest of them unless Rue's racket's stopped.
What do you mean?
Stuff she gets ain't always good. There's a lot of mysterious deaths around here.
Think I got the hang of it now, Kath?
Good. It'll be the same system as before. You'll get it tonight.
What?
Oh, it's just something to help us sleep better. Do you want to do this one?
Oh, yep. Okay, Waterloo customers.
Right. I have two conditioners and shampoo. God, look at those mopping shots.
What would you like?
Nothing, thank you.
Are you sure? Yes. It's the only place in town. You know spiders on the rocks.
Right. That's exactly where you should be.
If you don't want to buy, that's your business.
I just want you to know that I don't approve and the cheats never prosper. Yeah.
Thank you, Merle. Excuse me, there are other people waiting.
Yeah, she's carrying. Why don't you cheer up and buy some of your sour old things?
Oh, hey, what about these? They're my favourites.
Oh, all right, just for you, Mel. One pack of biscuits won't hurt. That's better.
Put on my account.
Would you like something to wash that down with?
Oh, yeah? Two brandies, thanks.
Right, that'll be $10 and just sign here, please. Not bad for someone who didn't want to buy anything.
Come.
Yeah, well, don't come whinging to me when she rips you off.
Crack the salts, have you?
Don't sound too happy yourself.
What do you reckon with Maxwell lording it over everyone?
Jeez. All the top dogs I've seen come and go. Made a real mess of it.
She made a real mess of me. I copped a takeover.
Jeez, she tried to do the right thing by the girls. Well, if I could have another crack at her, I'd shove that lead right down her throat.
You can forget that, but we could find another way to choke the bitch.
Yeah?
Hit her where it hurts the most.
Oh, no, I'm not taking on Merle.
No, the shop. We got to take over the shop.
She's got Adams and the freak backing
up. Not for long. If we can make her scare more trouble than it's worth, they dump her. We show Reno where the team to put it right. That'll hurt Maxwell more than any thumping you can give her.
You could be right, Simpson. We've got to fix it so... Hey, the booze!
What booze? Well, don't let me stop you.
We'll talk about it later. I've got to go and get my hair permed.
What are you talking about?
Oh, nothing.
Don't you trust her, Alice? If you've got plans...
What if I have?
Well, then you should trust your friends. Me. Now, what is it?
Friends. I suppose you bought that lot down at Woolies down the road.
Look, I didn't want to buy it any more than you would want to. Just that I felt sorry for Merle.
Big deal. At least I know where I stand with Simpson. Hope you enjoy your bickies.
Listen, Alice, come back.
So you reckon once she's down, she'll stay down?
Yeah, Rue's a coward. You'll be too good for her. G'day, Slammer. How's the leg?
What about her backup?
Won't have none. One look at you in action and they'll leave her for dust. Rue will be dog meat.
Just cut the crap and give it to me straight. You say she's got a screw on side.
Sure, but don't worry. Cynthia's out of action for a while.
Cynthia Leach? Oh, forget it. I'll find some other way of helping Bongo.
She's on long service leave. 3 months. Rue's on her lonesome. Once she's fixed, Cynthia won't be bothered picking up the pieces. She'll back you.
If this Rue's as weak as you say, how come some other bastard hasn't come and done her in?
Drugs. Just about everybody here's hooked on something. You name it, she'll get it.
Yeah, Bongo always did have trouble saying no.
Well, that's your big chance to dry him out. But I wouldn't leave it for too long. Get her, or the screws will get you.
Going to be a new top dog.
Cut the crap. How long before they miss us on reg?
A couple of minutes.
Where did Brumby shoot through?
Right here, shh.
Right, down here. Telecom Blackmore style. Into the hole, keep your voice low and not too long.
Bongo. Can you hear me, Bongo?
Keep it down.
Ree! I ain't beauty. Let's go for a swim.
Old Bongo, are you doped again? You've got to stop taking that stuff. It'll kill you.
Yeah. Yeah, the stuff. Bring the stuff, Rue.
Not Rue. It's Rita. It's Rita. Listen to me, baby brother. I'm going to help you. I love you. I'm going to fight Rue and stop that junk getting in. Maybe you'll have a chance.
I took the timing chain cover and... You remember, right?
Listen to me, Bongo. I'm going to fight Rue. I'm going to stop that crap coming in. I know you can't help yourself, Bongo, so I'm going to help you.
Rue? No, you can't fight her.
She's too...
What about Rue, Bongo?
Screw, quick. Hang on, what about Rue? What was it going to say?
I know, but if we don't POQ, there's not going to be any fight going on. We'll both be in the pit.
I want that bitch!
Sure, but it'll take a little time just to set it up.
If you'd seen as many fights as I have, you wouldn't be as sure of yourself.
Connors is fast on her feet. She's young, she hits hard.
It's Rue Morgan's home ground. She's not pretty to watch, but by God, she gets the job done.
That's precisely my point. She's so used to getting away with the dirty tricks, she's become too sure of herself. Bound to come unstuck sooner or later.
My money says it'll be later. Taking care of security?
Of course. Visitors will be restricted to the East Wing.
Pity we can't throw it open to the public. They'd pay heaps for ringside seats.
Yeah, bloodthirsty lot.
Usual bet.
Well, if you don't mind losing it, sir.
Care to double it?
Well, fine by me.
Good. Because according to the pipeline, the women are offering 8-1 about Connors.
I'll raise you 4.
Chocolate or ginger nut?
Well, I'm hardly going to raise you 4 chocolates, am I? I'm not made of biscuits.
Sorry, I forgot. Miss Lexi was here. She used to be really good at this game.
Yeah, when I heard about her, I'm glad she's not. She's with a lot. Hey, Alice, do you want a game?
What am I supposed to bet with?
Well, why don't they do some biscuits? Chocolate, if you like.
Some fairy floss. Some of us don't buy biscuits or anything else from that shop. Mm.
You're betting.
Hey, Alice. You can have some of mine.
Sit back, I haven't finished yet.
Don't forget the dots.
Hey, Merle, where's Kath?
I don't know, in the shop maybe. Do you want me to go and get her?
No, I don't want you to go and get her. Now sit down.
Hey, Merle, what do you want to be a boon for?
Because it's better than being a frizzy-haired slag like you.
Oh, isn't it?
Why should I? I'm having fun.
Because we're in this together, that's
why.
Can
you stop eating the money, Lorelei?
Oh. Can't do nothing till Maxwell gets here.
Look, don't worry, she can't spend all day in the bloody shop.
Hey, geez, what if she does? What if she stays?
What if you just shut up and stop worrying?
Hello, Merle.
Hey,
That looks nice.
G'day, Kat. I'm going to make a corroboree.
A corroboree.
Corroboree.
Is there a story that goes with that face?
Yeah. God made the gubbers. He was feeling very slack. God got very tired and forgot to paint them black. Oh, that's a nice rhyme.
Don't think it's supposed to be, Laurie. Look, will you stop eating the money? You're going to be as fat as Delia for your court appearance tomorrow.
So silly. Fat girl is exactly the same as a thin girl.
You're pleading guilty, are you? Pleading guilty, you're going to go for a
Mrs. Pringle,
you
got
the photos of our last session?
Yes, I have, Lorelei.
What are they like?
Well, I haven't looked at them myself yet. Oh. I thought that in all fairness, you should see them first.
How could you wait?
Oh, no. That looks very nice.
Will you take a picture of me? Because I'm going to make a didgeridoo.
A didgeridoo.
A didgeridoo. Oh,
well, yes, I suppose we could afford one of you.
Mrs. Pringle, look, my head's not even in this one. Look, where are my legs?
Well, I'm
off. Neither of us are in this one.
I'm sorry, ladies, but I'm used to a little automatic.
Yes, his name's Mervyn.
Oh, well, I am very sorry, but practice makes perfect. Now show me where I went wrong.
Pretty fancy trick. I thought we'd have to smash a window.
Oh, I could have picked that lock in kindergarten.
Hey, this is great. Just like when Sean and me broke into old man Corrigan's store back home.
Yeah, let's go.
Oh, jeez. From the back. Take him from the back. That way she won't know she's been ripped off so quick.
Hey, that's good thinking.
Give us more of a chance to flog it to the others before she clicks. Even then, she won't be able to prove a thing.
Well, we're not going to sell this stuff.
No, we're going to give it away. You keep going. I'm going to find a little hiding place for the booze.
Hey, yeah, we'll be just like Robin Hood, you know, stealing from the rich, giving to the poor.
Oh, who's going to blame Maid Marian?
Hey.
Just joking. It's got to be here somewhere. We're going to make a killing on that booze.
I mean it. Look, we're doing this to get back at Maxwell, not make money out of the women.
You're serious, aren't you?
You're dead bloody serious. Too right I am. We're not making a profit out of it. We're doing this for everyone, not just us.
Yeah, well, you might be. I'm not. That Robin Hood crap's really got to you, hasn't it? You can give yours away, but I'm flogging mine.
I mean it, Spider. We're giving it away or I'm chucking you out of here right now.
I told you I was going to make a didgeridoo. Look.
Yeah, that's very nice, Mel. But what about this mess?
Oh, I'll pack it up and put it back.
I don't think that's such a good idea. Now, how about we get rid of it before someone sees it? It's all out in the corridor.
All right, but can I save some for the corroboree?
We'll see.
Just have a wedding, did we?
Look, Mr. Adams, I'm going to make a corroboree.
Mel. Go and take the makeup off your face, please.
Oh, God, better clean this up first.
Now, please, Mel.
All right.
So, top dog, eh?
News travels fast.
I'm surprised Jenkins didn't tear you apart.
The women voted me in. She wouldn't dare.
As long as your back isn't turned. I hope this isn't going to change anything. You, me, and the shop.
On the contrary. Connors was our first stumbling block. She's gone. Spider's little racket has been broken, and she knows who holds the power if she tries anything. And our big problem with Alice has been cured with a flick of the wrist.
Three down and none to go.
Right. All the contenders are out of action. There won't be any more, not for a long time. As long as you and Ferguson do your job.
It's like being Father Christmas giving this stuff away, and it's Maxwell's shout.
First Robin Hood, now Father Christmas. What are we doing in here?
Jeez, wish you were here to see this, Reet.
Yeah, well, she's not. Let's go.
Hey, wonder if Abbo's our Father Christmas.
Hey, you're not giving her any.
Yeah, and something out of your bag too.
No way, not unless it's got strychnine in it.
Quick, whinge and wheel and give us something
now. All right, lay off. What's got into you?
Nothing you'd understand. Some of us have got friends.
Oh, God.
When you get back, Reet. Come on, let's give the rest of this stuff away.
Yeah, come on.
Just sitting around doing nothing's really getting on my wick.
You'll get used to it.
Like hell. What's this lot up to?
Search me.
Hey, what's going on?
Take it easy. Must be fire.
Fire? Didn't think you'd have one in this dump.
We don't. Not official. Rue's got her own racket.
Is that so? She's just gone into business. So you're Rue Morgan?
I've got a bone to pick with you.
Is that your mouth, or you're just running it in for someone else? Do I look like Rue Morgan? Hey, girls, she wants Rue. Suppose we better let her see her. Onions, you wait there.
I hope Morgan isn't going to disappoint us. It makes the women restless.
Probably just getting by up out of the way. How are things, Brumby, now? Morgan won't be far behind. I think our girl Morgan might be in trouble, Mr. Craven.
How do you figure that?
Have you seen Connors up close? She's more than 6 foot tall.
It's not the size of the dog in the fight, Mr. Walters. It's the size of the fight in the dog.
Go and kill him!
Come on.
Buy up, go all right?
No problems.
Doesn't look like this will be a problem either. Staying close, you two.
Contender for the heavyweight title, are we?
Stop peddling that junk in here and you can keep it.
Oh, listen to that. Blackmore's very own moral majority.
Sounds more like a minority to me.
I want one rule made
clear. Rule! This ain't Wentworth, honey.
Too late to change your bet, Mr. Walters. Maybe one of these men will take it.
I think I'll stay with Connors.
I think the first round goes to the local girl.
I don't think it's over yet. Looks like we'll get ourselves a new top dog, Governor.
Like hell we have.
Don't think losing a bet meant so much to you.
I want you to stop it. The women are turning against Morgan.
You can see that she's being beaten.
Get down there and break it up, all of you.
Who shall we say is the winner?
That's an order, Mr. Walters. Move it. Out.
Oh, boys. Down there for a while.
You bastard! You could see I was winning!
Fighting's not allowed at Blackmore. And neither's using language like that.
You mean beating Morgan's not allowed? You and your mongrel mates were watching the whole thing, weren't you? Craven get his rocks off on me, did he? Have you? I bet you had money on the stinking bitch.
Matter of fact, I had my money on you.
I saved your life, screw. You go back and tell your mates not to back Rue again, because the next time I see her, I'm going to kill her. And that bit's a dancer!
Maxwell. I thought I heard someone in here. You're not thinking of opening the shop, are you? It's after hours.
No, I'm just doing a bit of tidying up, that's all.
Well, looks like it's going to take off. You'll need another shopping day soon.
Yes, sooner than I expected.
Is anything wrong?
Oh, just the rigors of retail. You're responsible for everything from customer relations to shoplifting.
Well, I hope there'll be none of that. Well, don't be too long in here, OK?
OK.
I did one telecommercial once.
Oh, yeah? What for?
Candied-coated coconut creams.
Oh, hate them.
Yeah, me too now.
Why?
Well, we started filming this thing at 7 o'clock in the morning, right up in the hills. And they put all the models in this dinky little train and rocked it all over the place to make it look like we were trucking along. And we had to pretend like we were having a real good time and yell out, "We love candied coconut creams." You know, then pop a few.
Oh, is that easy money?
You reckon? We were there till 1 o'clock eating these things. And then we had lunch. Marinara. Then back into the dinky little train. And at 4 o'clock, you know, we could go home.
What happened?
Well, nothing. We're a huge success. But I've never been able to look at a candied coated coconut cream since then.
You make me laugh from my mask is starting to cry.
Yeah, well, it's about time you did laugh. Take your mind off Zoe. Lurch and I hear you crying at night.
No, I can't help it sometimes.
Yeah, well, let her rip. You know, I never had a kid or nothing, but I'm not short on imagination. And this nail polish has had, it's like tacky glue.
Yeah, help yourself to the bottom of my locker.
Yeah?
Think you'll ever have a kid?
Rather have a dishwasher. You know, I'm getting a bit domestic, but I'm not really plucky about it. Whoa, what a stash!
Huh?
Moisturizers! Disintegrants! Chocolates! Shampoos!
Where did this all come from?
You're asking me?
Hey, look what I got!
Where from? Don't know, they was in me dorm, all tucked up with me comics. And Ruthie's got biscuits and Brenda's got sherbet bombs, but she won't swap them.
Are we comparing presents in here?
Yeah,
a whole carton of cigs. Next time I'd like unfilled it, but I'm not complaining.
Gee, Sam's forgotten me, I swear I'm gonna take out a contract. Whoa! What's going on?
Oh, it must be from the shop.
Yeah. Well, you've got to hand it to them home deliveries. I mean, it's so civilised without so much mention of a payment.
Like I say, what the hell's going on?
I want that stuff back. What makes you think it was us?
Yeah. Why us?
Because you two teamed up for a reason, and I suspect it was to get at me. Well, I've been hit, and I don't think I have to look any further. I'm going to get that stuff back. I've got the numbers.
You reckon?
Maybe you have, maybe you haven't.
What are you talking about?
Being top dog. One minute you're in and next minute you're out.
Right.
Well, you should know.
Go and have a look at yourselves, girls. It's only a rumour that Christmas comes but once a year.
Kath, you gave them all the presents, didn't you?
Of course.
In a pig's eye.
Where else would they have come from? It's just a little goodwill gesture. I left something in every cell.
Well, hey, let's go.
You're a liar. Do you mean you haven't found yours yet? Don't tell me I forgot. I'm sure I would have left something very special for you two.
Yeah, three cheers for Kath in the shop. Hip hip.
Hey,
hey, babies aren't too good.
Hey, why don't you go and have a look at what your surprise is?
I reckon I got it already.
But he wouldn't budge. He just kept telling me that she was on a charge and had lost all privileges.
And you couldn't do anything?
Outside of sitting there and doing a slow burn, no, I couldn't.
No one gets around Craven. And the fact that Connors is already on a charge at Blackmore proves that I was right in sending her there.
Don't kid yourself, Joan. Craven would put you on a charge if you looked sideways at him.
Oh, Blackmore is high security, and he's just the one to enforce it. In my opinion, the service could do with a lot more with his professionalism.
When do you think you will be able to see Connors?
When Craven's ready. But I get a feeling that he's got special treatment for Rita.
Possibly. Doesn't like assertive women.
Ah, and you do the man an injustice. Craven hates all women and he hates all prisoners and he hates all blacks. He hates women who aren't prisoners, prisoners who aren't blacks and blacks who aren't prisoners. He's quite broad-minded, really.
Excuse me. Can I restock the staff room now, please, Mrs. Reynolds?
I'll escort her, Governor.
Let's talk in my office.
Right.
There's been a break-in at the shop.
Contraband?
No, they didn't find that, just the stock off the shelves. They didn't get everything, but enough to knock down the takings.
You reported this?
No, of course not.
Good, keep it that way. This could close us down.
I think that's what they're counting on.
Who?
Simpson and Jenkins. I confronted them with it. They doled the stuff out to the women to win them over.
And did they?
No, I stepped in and took the credit.
Gotta hand it to you, Maxwell, you're quite an asset. Well, no real damage done.
Just to the profit margin.
Oh, not even that. They'll pay, eventually.
I've been thinking about you, Tucker. And I've come to the conclusion that I really don't like you. I don't know why, but I really don't.
Oh, please, Ray, don't.
Don't what, Tucker?
Hurt me.
And you talked me out of it. That's why Craven sent you here, so you could talk me out of it.
I can't.
I know. Remember this?
No.
Remember it now? Oh, whose side were you on, Tucker? Oh. Come on, answer me! Oh. Whose side?
Yours, Ruth.
Oh,
yours,
and you must have got the name wrong. I heard you beckon Connors.
No, I wasn't. It wasn't
Why
me.
Not? She's pretty good, huh? Oh. But you already knew all about that, didn't you?
What's going on in here?
Oh, you know, Tucker, Mr. Waters. Always acting the goat.
Carry on.
Too old, but that's why he stopped it.
Yeah, well, I'm not real pleased myself. I had a whole lot of bull laid on me about Morgan.
Yeah, well, we figured it was the only way you'd take her on.
Yeah, well, you figured all wrong. And Brumby's gonna understand that when I get out of here.
Brumby's gonna be too punchy to understand anything. Rue's tearing her apart for backing you, and chances are I'll be next.
Rue's gonna be next.
You're the only one who can do it, Connors. All the women think so.
Would they back me?
Sure.
If you're not being straight with me.
I am. They'll back you.
How many?
More than half. And when you get Rue, the rest will come over. Not Onions and Aunt Harriet, but the others for sure. You gonna take Rue on?
I already have.
Oh! Oh, no more, please! Oh.
You're gonna pay.
I've got good information.
There's nothing you can tell me.
Yeah, I can. You'll get Connors with it. You'll have something on her. It's true.
Talk.
My brother's here.
Whereabouts?
Inside. Bongo Connors. Bongo's Rita's brother. You can use it, can't you, Ray? Can't you?
I can use it.
Yes?
Blackmore's ex-heavyweight champion to see you, Governor.
Bring her in.
Come on. Connors was making a real mess of you, wasn't she? You're lucky the Governor called it off.
I gave as good as I got.
I'm talking about Connors, not the Brumby. It's nice to know you can still go a round or two with the bantamweight, though, isn't it?
That's enough, Mr. Walters. He's right. I think you're starting to show your age, Rue.
I can handle her.
Not from where I was standing. She had it all over you.
That was then. Round two's gonna be all mine. It won't be no technical knockout either.
You're pretty silly, Rue, but you're not stupid. You won't go up against her again. What's your angle?
Her brothers. Bongo Connors. That's news to you, huh? Maybe you're the one who's losing his grip on things. That's dangerous around here.
So what's your next move?
I'm going to talk to him if he's not too out of it. Get him to lean on Connors. You clear it with Chandler?
I'll clear it. I don't want my two top dogs tearing one another's throats out.
No, get
it. Careful, Rue. Connors look very nice out there today.
No, lay off, will you? I ache all over.
This'll help take your mind off it.
Connors! Get any more of your folks in here, you can start a reunion.
What do you mean?
Your sister.
What about it?
She's headed for trouble, Bongo. So you gotta talk to her. Tell her to cool it and lay off. Got it?
No.
Just do like I say. Be a big brother. Just this once.
It can't be done, Rue. You see, Rita, she looks after herself and her own. She won't even listen to no one, not even
She's
me.
She's gonna be real sorry.
What's the matter? Can't you handle her?
I am handling her.
You're running scared, Rue. Straight to me. That's a change, eh? That's real funny. You got the shakes yet? Because they'll come. You'll sweat real bad because Reed's gonna go right through you. I'd give a hit to see that fight. She's all right, eh?
Just you talk to her, and this is yours. Cross me. And I'll see to it you go cold turkey. And I'll make sure you can't get the stuff off anyone. You ready for that?
Hey, Tucker, here. Come here. I want a meeting with Rita Connors. You set it up.
Maybe. It'll cost you.
I'm flat. No, nothing.
I said it'll cost you. It costs me.
I'm telling you, it's too risky. If the screws don't get us, Rue will.
Rue knows what's up.
What do you mean?
She knows. That's all. I squared it with the screws. Come on! Rita?
You little ripper! You open that?
Yeah, I'm okay. I heard about the fight. You did great.
I had a Bongo, and I'll have her next time too.
No!
What?
Lay off her. You're better off.
Better off? Are you out of it? No.
Please back off. I'm asking you. Do you hear me? Do you hear me? Answer me, please. Will you do it?
I hear you.
Will you do it? For me?
You're a message boy, aren't you?
No!
What was your price? A hit? Was that it?
You got it all wrong. It's for you. It's for your own good.
Oh, come clean with me, Bongo. I can't take this stinking lion.
I am.
I said come clean. She sent you, didn't she?
No.
He's lying.
Shut up.
She won't deal with him unless he brings you around.
Shut up, you stupid bitch.
Fight the bitch like I did, Bongo, and fight the smack. I'm gonna get her.
No, please don't.
I'm gonna get her for both of us, for everyone in here.
She can do it. She can get Rue. You're the only one, Rita.
Shut up.
I'll I'll get you out of here, Bongo. I'll get you through this and I'll get you out of here. Bongo! Bongo!
Well, what are you doing here? You should have propped up Black Mortal. They did let you see her.
I couldn't. They wouldn't let me through.
It's your job to get through.
Now, I know you're upset and you're worried. I am too. But you're talking off the top of your head. You don't know Blackmore and you don't know Craven.
I've heard plenty.
Well, it's all true. That's why they wouldn't let me in to see her. I left her food and that's the best I could do.
You can't tell us that story, you promised. Sorry. It's all right, Merle. No, I can't.
You promised.
What story?
A Dreamtime story. Hey, maybe you could tell it. You're black.
Oh, yeah, like a coconut. Black on the outside, white on the inside.
Go on. I'll ask Mrs. Morris if you can come to the rec room and tell everybody.
Okay. I'll tell a Dreamtime story.
Are you crazy? We'll never do it.
You can get to the workshop, can't you?
Sure, but we can't break you out of there.
Listen, you want me to break Rue, don't you?
Yes.
Well, let's do it. If you stuff it up, you'll only end up in here with me. If you come through, I promise I'll break her, Craven, and this whole stinking hole.
How?
A riot. One like the governor and his goons have never seen.
$500 then.
No, I don't want to play nothing.
I've done my face, my nails, my hands, my feet. You know, I spend the whole week waiting for Saturday, and when it gets here, it bores me rigid.
Yeah, and Sundays are even worse.
That's because the next day's Mondays.
Hey, everyone, you've got to listen.
To what?
Pamela, she's going to tell us a story, aren't you?
Looks like it.
Go ahead, but you're talking to yourself as far as I'm concerned. It's a Dreamtime story.
Does that mean it'll put us to sleep?
Nah, and if you don't want to listen, you can just buzz off.
Ooh.
Well, Ostaver's got a travelling salesman in it.
or there once was a girl from Wakenny who led
all
a young...
All right, all right. Now, suit yourselves whether you listen or not, but don't interrupt.
Yeah.
Don't interrupt.
This story's from the Wilbur-Lew people, about the black swans.
As if that days weren't boring enough.
I said don't you interrupt.
Oh, right.
Long, long time ago in the dream time, a group of women, the Wilbur-Lew, owned the only boomerangs in the world.
Yeah, and the Japanese took over the franchise.
Yeah, sorry.
The men of the surrounding tribe had often planned to seize the weapons by force, but since the Wilbur-Lew used many powerful death chants to protect themselves, they decided to acquire the boomerangs by trickery. So, two of the men of the tribe changed themselves into white swans and flew to a waterhole near the women's camp. The men felt sure that when the white swans flew overhead, the Wilbur-Lew, forgetting about the boomerangs, would rush out to see the strange birds. The scheme worked perfectly. As soon as the camp was empty, the men who were hiding nearby raced in and grabbed the boomerangs and ran. The women, screaming with rage, rushed out to punish the thieves. But they had gone. So the women then returned to attack the swan.
Come on, please.
Take this and distract the screws so they'll think it's own brood. Now run.
Oi.
Come on. Again, I can't get it.
Come on, you'll do it.
It's not gonna work. We'll never do it.
Slamming the bloody thing, do it!
Get the others rounded up. Go on. This joint's gonna be crawling with screws.
Take me out of here. You'll take them on by yourself.
The swans had flown to a lily-covered lagoon, which, unknown to them, was the home of the eagles. Angry at the intrusion, the eagles picked up the swans in their powerful claws and carried them far south to a great desert. Savagely attacking the swans and tearing out their feathers, the eagles left their victims on the ground, bleeding and almost naked. But a large flock of crows plucked feathers from their own bodies and let them fall like a shower on the naked birds. "The eagles are our enemies too," they said. "Our feathers will protect you and help you grow strong. Today, the black feathers of the crows cover almost every part of the swans, but the white feathers on the tips of their wings and the blood on their beaks still remain.
underway. Come on, quick!
What's going on out there?
They're breaking Rita out of the pound. The whole joint's going up. And she's looking for you. She's pretty cut up about Bongo and she says she's going to waste her room.
Hypertank 6 men and cover the grounds. Waters the east wing. I don't want one prisoner out of the restricted area. Is that understood? If you see one, fire. If you see now, move! Move!
Yeah, baby, yeah. This is going to be the round we didn't finish. This is going to be your last round, Rue. If that's your party, you haven't got time for this.
Different than on the inside, the sun still shines.